Senator Kemp Hannon. Thanks for tuning in. We're going to discuss organ donations, saving lives today. We're joined with Miriam Perez, who is a nurse but has been very longly associated with the Alliance for Donation and public speaking and can explain this quite well. And the Alliance itself is directed by Ellen Hollander, who is a real pro at government and trying to move policy and develop policy. And this is one of the most important policies we have in terms of saving lives. We have, I think, over 170,000 people who are alive in the United States today because they've been the successful recipients of an organ. And so, Mary, why don't you just tell us a little bit about the mission of the of your alliance?
Well, we are the New York Organ Donor Network, and we are the organ procurement organization in the city. However, we're the second largest in the nation. And our mission is to get the most viable, equitable organs for all the public who need them, and also to educate the families so that they can make an informed consent about donation.
And how many people are on a waiting list in New York right now whose lives could be really extended, perpetuated, made sure. better?
Well, there are about 9,600 people in New York State waiting for an organ transplant, for a second chance. Really.
Now, what type of organ is usually the most popular on the list?
Well, the most popular is the kidney. You know, there are more people waiting for kidneys, and that's only because they have an alternative treatment. They have a dialysis machine. Those persons waiting for lungs, hearts, livers, they die. So the list is never that long because, unfortunately, they don't have an option.
There's so few things that, in terms of intervention by medical professionals these days, that can absolutely save lives, and this is one of them.
Absolutely. It's a treatment that is now successful in the 90th percentile, so why not do it?
How does one go about saying, I'm willing to give an organ?
Well, it's very simple today because we now have a registry of consent. That's the New York State Donor Registry. And all you have to do is sign up in the Department of Motor Vehicles and check off that you want to be an organ donor. Or you can always call our office at 1-800-GIFT-4-NEW-YORK. And you can ask for a registry form. And you can fill out the form. Here's a form. And all you have to do is fill it out and make your wishes known. You can identify which organs or tissues you'd like to donate and sign it, and that will place you on the registry.
So you just have to put your name, address, and check off the organs.
That's it. It's very simple.
Now, what's the difficulty of doing it if you are a donor?
Well, the difficulty is only your own personal myths and misconceptions that you may have about it. Many people just don't know enough about it. There's a lack of information out there. There's the fear of mutilation. There's fear that, you know, you won't go to heaven with all your organs. These are all things that people perceive. They think their religion maybe doesn't stop them, when in fact all religions support donation. Donation is actually the highest gift you can give to someone, and it's the most religious act you can ever do, is to save a life. So many, all the religions support it.
One of the most enlightening, uplifting things I did in 2009 was to give our Liberty Medal to a teacher who gave a kidney to one of her students. And there had been no family relationship. She just saw that this was an individual who had a great life ahead of him, and she thought that this would be an appropriate thing to do. And it's just been absolutely marvelous in terms of the personal courage and the example to the rest of society in Nassau County.
Oh, absolutely. Now, you know, it's sad to say, it's good to say, but also sad that more people are stepping up to actually give part of themselves while they're alive to save a loved one, or even a stranger, as you said.
And this is something, though, but the number of donations grows so slowly. It is growing.
Yes, but very slowly. And sadly, last year, for example, in our service area, we only had 285 donors. The good thing about that, however, is that one donor can save up to 8 lives and improve the quality of life for 50 others through tissue donation.
Wow.
So one donor could really save so many people.
Now, here's a hardball, Ms. Hollander. Where do we do next to kind of increase the pool of people knowing that they can donate, willing to donate?
Well, a good portion of the Alliance's efforts, and I should say that the Alliance is made up of the 4 organ procurement organizations and the 4 eye and tissue banks in the state of New York, located in Buffalo, Rochester, Albany, New York, and with branches in Syracuse and Long Island. So we cover the entire state. And what the alliance, one of our primary functions is to bring us together as an alliance to do legislative advocacy in terms of improving the operation of the registry, the efficiency of the registry. One of our issues, for example, is the fact that New York will not allow for an electronic signature in registering to be an organ, eye, and tissue donor. And so we have some legislation that is directed at that. We have a number of educational outreach programs. We are working on collaborative activities with other alliances and associations in the state of New York, all to bring everything together to promote organ, eye, and tissue donation, to increase the donor registry.
And what would be some of your projects that would be doing that?
Well, we are, in the past year, have been working with the New York State Association of County Clerks. I don't like to throw a lot of numbers around, but 98% of the people who register do so when they go to their DMVs and renew their license. And to me, that was when I started in this field, a very startling statistic, because people go to their DMVs not with a health issue on their mind, but with a motor vehicle transaction issue on their mind. And I think people want to just get in and out as soon as possible. And do you have a heart on your driver's license? The New York State Department of Motor Vehicle runs a number of offices, but the 51 county clerks, including on Long Island, county clerks run 131 DMV offices in the state of New York. So we talk in the alliance about our mission being raising awareness about donation, but I'm beginning to think that we should concentrate on action, getting people to sign up. And the action takes place in DMV offices. So we have initiated a collaborative effort with the County Clerks Association. They have been extremely supportive. In fact, around the state, beginning April 1st, they took up the challenge, and they are promoting organ, eye, and tissue donation in the county clerk's offices, and we're very appreciative of their efforts.
Well, and it makes it a lot easier now that for the last decade, the motor vehicle offices are a lot more efficient than they've ever been.
Yes.
I mean, growing up, it used to be that was the worst thing.
Long waits.
But I'm holding up the card, my driver's license, and there's a little space on that where you could write it out, but that's not the donor,
correct.
The registry.
That is sort of a misconception.
And we're trying to get and I actually say it's some of the most valuable 1 square inch in the entire state. Because,
that's right.
But we want people to be able to check not whether they've written on their card, but whether they're on the organ donation registry.
Right.
Is there a website you can check that registration?
The Department of Health runs the website. You can get to the website through the DOH online. They have an online registry. The Alliance for Donation.org, if you go to our website, and there's an icon where you can click on that gets you right to the registry.
Oh, that's far better, because getting to the Department of Health
that's why I mention it.
It's a mass of information.
Yes, it is easier to go through.
So just go to your website,
correct.
Which we'll have up on the screen.
That will get you right in to where you can
and
register.
And you can check if you're registered or
yes.
not.
Yes, yes.
And it's amazing as people go through more and more of their friends with medical problems or end-of-life problems that we become aware of what the possibilities are to help people.
Correct.
It's not something all of a sudden as high school or college we get aware of at all.
Yes, more and more people are becoming aware. In fact, we were working with Ms. Hollander on a medical student program that was very efficient. We even have to educate the doctors and nurses, start from there, and then filter out into the communities, because that is the hub of the education mainly for health.
Oh, certainly, and the nurses would be the prime interaction in a hospital sure. setting. One of the things we first did probably 10 years ago was to remove hospitals from the involvement in talking to the patients or their families about donating organs, and set up the whole network for you, the Alliance, to do the talking to the families so there'd be no conflict of interest
exactly.
with anybody in the hospital or anyone in the medical professions.
That's right. That's still how we do it. We actually set up collaborative teams. Now we work collaboratively, but we ask the hospital to allow us to ask for consent so there is no conflict of interest.
And I think that works even better because now we've had hospitals evolve so that they have folks who are trained in palliative care and end-of-life care.
Yes.
And there is a counseling sense of this. I'm not so sure it's all the time in every hospital because of the busy nature of them, but at least it is part of their world and part of their arena.
Yes. I also want to mention that one of the newer amendments to the public health law is now that the healthcare proxy can actually give consent for organ donation. Prior to that, they couldn't, and now they can. And also the person who's responsible for burying the body, that has a real high priority on the consent issue. So
it's come a long way. I mean, and part of what we just evolved, and finally, after 15 years, we have passed the family health care decision making so that adults, such as a spouse, can make a health care decision for their spouse,
yes.
husband or wife. People were very surprised to learn beforehand that was not an automatic right.
Exactly.
So we'd hope that with this more sensitivity and more knowledge about health care, the whole health care debate this year
sure.
in the nation, we might get a little more sense of what we could do for organ donation. You
That's
can absolutely
right.
save lives.
Absolutely. We have so many people waiting, and you know, everyone wants an organ, but then who's going to give them?
Yes.
And that's the dilemma we have. There's a huge gap between wanting and receiving.
Well, we also have to let people know that there's a system of a waiting list that's pretty fair. There's standards. It's public. There's no jumping ahead. You have to be entitled.
That's right.
That we're trying to take better care of the donors, so make sure their health insurance covers any of the procedures that are there. There's some counseling. So there is a whole area around just the act of donating that,
exactly.
that has to be addressed.
Yes, there's Miriam, so many things.
Miriam mentioned a medical education project that we had. We also have a public education project working with college students to use social media, Facebook, YouTube, to get the message out there where it's a viral, they pass along to their friends the importance of donation. So we have that project. And we would love to see that there be some type of education in high schools, health education, to raise awareness about donation, a segment of the health education curriculum to raise awareness.
Very difficult.
I remember
in high school the one classmate, I still remember his name and the circumstances, who died. He had a brain aneurysm, but it was literally, I probably was 15 and the first time that I experienced death. And you know, it's a new thing, and that's why I say as you
right.
get older and older, you really understand all the aspects of the medical system better.
Absolutely.
And yet, we haven't been able to increase this one part about donations even more right. than we should.
You know, sadly, the New York State is one of the lowest states with the lowest enrollments in New York State. We are one of the last ones. States like Oregon has 74% of their population enrolled on the registry. And in New York, it's only 13%.
Well, we have a long, long
way
to
go. So
and making that registry a lot more available than hidden. So if you can keep up the good work, all New Yorkers' lives will be improved.
Absolutely.
But thank you for joining with us today.
Thank you so much for having us. We really appreciate that.
Thank you very much. I'm Senator Kemp Hannon. I'll see you again next time.